Tēnā koutou katoa, welcome to the show. Appliances, they used to be built to last, and when they broke down, we fixed them.
What an idea. Now, cheaper products are made en masse and biffed en masse too. We're throwing them out everywhere. It means a growing pile of e-waste in our landfills.
But as Jill discovered, there might be an easy answer, one that helps the environment and the customer too.
Every time Rory hits the hills, he puts his legs and his heart to the test.
It'd probably be around 150 beats per minute on average.
Same reading for many a glorious ride, until one.
I had, I think it was about 213 beats a minute.
A crazy reading.
Well, I knew either there was something badly wrong with me or that the heart rate monitor was broken.
Luckily, it was the monitor, but his heart still missed a beat. The monitor costs $170 and he'd only had it for 4 months. But no worries, the US company Wahoo sent a replacement at no cost. A brand new one. In fact, 3 new ones in just 18 months because of 3 fails. Number one.
So it lasted about 4 months before it just started giving these crazy readings, sent me a really quick replacement.
Number two.
Within a few days of using the second heart rate monitor, it was full of moisture, plastic, battery casing had kind of disintegrated, and once again, they just really quickly sent me another one.
And number three.
Just over a year, it stopped working. Started giving crazy readings again, and they just emailed me to say, what's your address? And they sent me another heart rate monitor. No questions asked.
Now, you might say, great customer service. But Rory would say,
it's terrible. People want products that last, that they can rely upon, and that work well for a long time. They don't want to be sending them back, receiving new ones, sending them back, receiving new ones, and just collecting junk plastic.
And look at the claims made by Wahoo.
On the social responsibility page of Wahoo's website, it says that they want to treat people and the planet like they want to be treated.
The company even boasts of its partnership with an organisation that ensures waste is recycled.
Slightly hypocritical, to say the least, that they partner with a charity and they just keep sending someone device after device after device. And at no point have they tried to recover the various bits of pieces and plastic.
We put that to Wahoo, but it simply replied it was focused on customer service.
A new firmware update has solved some of the main issues we've seen from returns.
And as far as its environmental commitment?
Our customer service team will always advise customers to do the right thing, as at present there is no global solution for consumer electronics products.
It got Rory thinking. The case with his heart monitor could apply to so many appliances. Quality goods like a fridge are generally expected to last 10 years, which could mean maybe 4 replacements in your lifetime. Cheap goods, well, you might need 20 times as many.
20 times the plastic, 20 times the metal, all of it probably going into landfill.
Choose washing machines, cars, compact displays and electrical tin openers.
But Kiwis love cheap. It makes us cheerful. But the feeling, like the product, doesn't always last. So e-waste, everything from fridges to phones, piles up. And we are one of the worst offenders for this in the world. Yay.
And to give you an idea of how bad, we're here at Eden Park. And to represent all the different types of e-waste that we chuck, we're using the humble toaster. So it's the equivalent of about 4,000 toasters
an hour,
which is about 2.5 million toasters every month. And I'm out of here because that's like 32 million toasters. Enough e-waste to fill this stadium every single year.
And it's not just consumers chucking the cheap stuff when it stops working, it's manufacturers too, as we exposed in this investigation with Consumer NZ. We loosened a wire in some food mixers, an easy repair, and inserted trackers, then took them back to where they were bought. The tracking showed the 2 cheap ones went straight to landfill.
They were just buried in a big hole in the ground.
The warehouse told us it will keep improving, while Kmart's recently said it's starting a trial where goods can be returned, but it wouldn't tell us what would happen to them. In the same investigation, the same loose wire test was carried out with pricier models. One was recycled, which is something, but the other
came here to the appliance outlet in Tamaki Makaurau, Auckland, where everyone really gets a bargain.
We're back to see how it sells products that have been returned to stores.
Basically anything we can take off the market that can be refurbished and put back into the public arena.
It's still a business, so has to make a profit, which isn't easy, as it has to pay for the returned products, plus...
We have to employ staff to refurbish it, we have to buy parts for the product, we have to warranty it as well, which all has cost.
But the benefits?
Yes, it keeps it out of landfill and it keeps the product going back into the market.
Consumer NZ would like to see more stores like this because...
We'd have access to really good quality products that are durable because they're made to last and be refurbished and resold. And you'd get those at a much better price.
And the appliance outlet would love to do more business, but only with products that make it worth their while.
So much of it is it's a disposable product. It's cheaply made, cheaply produced in China. It's sold at a cheap price. And you can't refurbish product like that and still make money.
Well, they'd have even more to cry about if giant TVs like this ended up in landfill. So why don't more companies make their products durable so that a second chance is worthwhile?
There's nothing that compels a manufacturer to make a product repairable. There's nothing even that compels them to do anything other than just throw their products straight into landfill. I mean, what the market's shown us over decades is that they're not going to do it by themselves. So they need a nudge.
How about a push?
They need something to incentivize them to actually go down this path, and legislation might be the answer to that.
So, Consumer New Zealand wants Kiwis to try this.
The French introduced a repairability label a couple of years ago that actually encourages manufacturers to compete on repairability. So you can shop and see this product's more repairable than this product. You don't just compete on price anymore, you compete on repairability and durability.
The rating would be based on availability of a repair manual, availability and price of spare parts, ease of taking the item apart, and life expectancy of the product.
And it relies on the idea that manufacturers are going to call each other out.
And just like the energy and water ratings we have, it needs to be a legal requirement.
Without that, we're left with just the good companies that would do it, and I'd say the majority of companies probably wouldn't.
So we've seen what happened with France and New Zealand in the Rugby World Cup. Imagine if we took the nation on in the game of repairability and won. We just need everyone on board.
I think it would be an absolute game changer. I think just the idea that it's a really light touch legislation that just allows and just nudges manufacturers to compete on something other than going for the lowest price.
Of course, we don't know if any leaders would support the labels, but Consumer New Zealand hopes they do. And if you do?
We've got a petition live at the moment. So yeah, I would go to consumer.org.nz and go and sign our petition for the repairability label.
Okay, I better go then.
Thank you.
I do like a good label everywhere, and I have trouble with goodbyes. So if I could keep a product and then get it fixed and bring it back into my life, emotionally, it'd be better for me.
Changing our mindset. And hey, that link to that petition is on our Facebook page.